Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, we're awake today. I love it. Welcome to church this morning. We are thrilled to have you join us. We're having our children's program today. We're so excited to see all the cute things that the kids do. It's one of my favorite times of Christmas, not gonna lie. After the service, if you see my husband who's back there, wish him a happy 40th birthday. I have the power of the microphone, so I can tell you. Happy birthday to my lovely Italian husband back there. So thank you for joining us. Please stand.
You all look stunned. Before you sit down and greet one another this morning and welcome someone to church that you haven't already had an opportunity to say hi to. You may be seated. And as Carrie said, welcome to church this morning. It's great to have you here as we gather together to worship the Lord, but also as we come together to fellowship with one another and to enjoy what the children and the teens have been working very hard at putting together this morning for us. And just reminding us what this time of year is all about. It's great that we get together with friends and family. It's great that we buy gifts for one another and Christmas concerts and all those things. But the true meaning of what this time of year is all about, right, of celebrating the birth of Christ and what that means and all for us in His God coming down in flesh and blood to show us and point us to the cross and to the empty tomb and to prepare a way for us for heaven. And so thank you for being here this morning as we gather together to worship Him. If you want to grab your bulletin, just a couple of announcements that I want to bring to your attention. this morning. Right after church, right after the service this morning, is a ministry that we call Chick Chat. For any of the women that want to stick around afterwards to enjoy some food and some fellowship. Next Sunday, we will not have Sunday school or the following Sunday. So Christmas Eve and New Year's Eve, we will not have Sunday school. But we will be having an 11 o'clock service next week, as well as a 6 p.m. candlelight communion, our Christmas Eve service. So that will be at 6 o'clock. And in our 6 o'clock service, we will be taking a special offering for a young couple, Brady and Sydney Bond, who are Wesleyan pastor family that are planting a church in Ithaca. Sometime next year in 2024, they're already there living there, and they're beginning to develop and a small group there, starting with prayer. And so we're going to be taking a special offering for them on Christmas Eve service, our 6 p.m. service, to just help them out in that endeavor. Also, this is the last Sunday to order your poinsettias for our Christmas Eve services for the 11 o'clock as well as the 6 o'clock. Right outside the church office in the hallway, right outside the door is a table that has some order forms on that, or see Carrie. And we will have those there for next our next Sunday service, both the 11 o'clock as well as the 6 o'clock service. I think that's all the announcements. There's some other? No, there's not. There's more.
Welcome. Cindy, can you come up here for a minute, please? So it's Christmas, so we have a nice gift for Pastor Carl. Add a few more things to this morning. And so I was thinking what I would say, and you never really know what I would say, but I was thinking what I would say. It's very true. So I was thinking of some scripture of what pastor means to us and to our church family. So 2 Timothy 4:2 says, "Preach the word, be prepared in season and in out of season, correct, rebuke, and encourage with great patience and careful instruction." And I think that's a great verse that we could put on our pastor this morning. And then Matthew 5:16, "In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify the Father in heaven." And I think that those two verses embody who you guys are and what you do for us. And we thank you, not just this season, but in all the seasons. Thank you for being true to the word, for reflecting Jesus, and for being a blessing to us all. So thank you. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you, Debbie and church family. Let's bow for prayer. Heavenly Father, we just come into your house this morning just as we are. We thank you that we don't have to dress up. We don't have to put on any kind of airs to come into your presence, that you just call us as we are. So this morning, Father, we come into your house with a lot of hurts, a lot of baggage that we're carrying, a lot of concerns, fears, but also, Father, with a grateful heart for who you are and what you've done for us. And so, Father, I just pray that as we come in, and today being a little bit different type of a service, Lord, that you would still speak to us. And I thank you that you love us too much to leave us the way that we are. Your word tells us that all of our fears and our concerns and our cares and our anxieties, that we can cast them on you because you love us, that you care for us. And that's what this time of year really is all about, you loving us so much that you sent your son to earth to eventually die for our sins so that we can have a right relationship with you. And so, Father, we just praise you and we thank you this morning. So, Lord, would you just inhabit this place as we worship you in song and the message that the kids are going to be sharing with us a little bit later on. Lord, just speak to our hearts and our lives, I pray. I ask all this in Christ's name. Amen. The worship team is going to sing a special song for us this morning, and then Greg and Sarah Humble and family are going to come and have our candle, Advent candle reading, as well as the lighting.
To sing and to have joy to the world.
Amen. Is that what you are singing this morning? Joy to the world. It's great to have the Humble family with us, and so they're going to come and do our candlelight reading as well as lighting our Advent candle this morning.
All right, third week of Advent. Joy. Many events in life muster joy within us. Can you think of some? Maybe it was a birth, a marriage, an ordination, or graduation, winning an important game, or completing a big contract. In all these accomplishments, joy may likely be a dominant emotion. Joy is a gift from the Lord.
Today marks the third week of Advent, a season recognized by the church around the world as a time to prepare our hearts and lives to welcome the coming of Jesus Christ at Christmas. We track this season by engaging in several rhythms, one of them being to light candles, one for each week leading up to Christmas Day. Today, we light the third candle, traditionally called the
second candle of joy.
The candle of joy.
Joy and rejoicing are common themes during Christmas time and occupy several traditional English carols and songs, including Joy to the World, O Come, Emmanuel, Angels We Have Heard on High, among many, many others.
While you might currently have a lot of Christmas tunes dancing through your head, know this, music that calls us to rejoice is on a deeper level, also calling us to worship. Worship and joy go hand in hand. Joy wells up in our hearts to the point of songs and laughter and dance. And when this joy and delight are directed at God, that is worship.
At Christmas, we are challenged to be filled with joy and to worship Christ Jesus, our King. If worship and rejoicing are difficult for you in this moment, ask God to help you worship. In Isaiah 61, verse 3, which Jesus later reads as a declaration of his purpose. In Luke 4, we read that the Holy Spirit anoints and empowers this in order to bestow upon us the oil of joy instead of mourning and garment of praise instead of a spirit of despair. God is ready to give. He teaches you to worship and joy and praise just as.
Please pray with me. Holy Spirit, we thank you for the joy you infuse within us. We ask you to help us praise you, God, in the midst of our sorrows and to choose our regardless of our circumstances. Jesus, we are grateful for the joy that surrounds your birth. Help us to be joy, filled rather than filled with despair. Fill us with your Holy Spirit, we pray, amen.
Please stand as we continue to worship.
Like the sun is.
Well, again, it's great to have you here this morning as we celebrate Christ's birth and hear what the children have been working, teens who have been working very hard at. I want to thank Debbie Lewis and Bailey Lewis, no relation, same last name, no relation, but for their hard work in getting the kids and teens ready for this morning. So give us just a second, and we will get things all set and ready, and then we'll turn it over to the kids.
A long time ago, in the city of Nazareth, there was a woman named Mary. Mary was promised to marry a man named Joseph, who lived there too.
One day, an angel from God came and talked to Mary.
He told Mary she was going to have a baby.
Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High.
What? How can this be?
The power of the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
Oh, okay.
Then the angel left.
Now Joseph wasn't sure what to do when he heard that Mary was going to have a baby.
So one night, while he was asleep, an angel came and talked to Joseph too.
Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary as your wife, for what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit.
Oh, okay.
And so that's just what he did.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all of the world should be registered.
Everyone, go to your own hometown so I can count you.
So Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem to be counted, because Joseph was of the house and line of David, and Bethlehem was known as the city of David.
I've traveled many moonless nights, cold and weary, with a babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you and chosen me now to carry your son. I am waiting in a silent prayer. I am frightened by the load I bear, in a world as cold as stone. Must I walk this path alone? Be with me now, be with me now. Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me, breath of heaven. Breath of heaven, lighten my darkness. Pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, do you wonder as you watch my face if a wiser one should have had my place? But I all I am,
the mercy of your plan. Help me be strong. Help me be. Help me. Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me, breath of heaven. Breath of heaven, light in my darkness. Pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, hold me together. Be forever near me, breath of heaven. Breath of heaven, light in my darkness. Pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, breath of heaven, breath of heaven.
Lots of other people there too. When there were so many people, in fact, that there was no room for them in the inn. So Mary and Joseph stayed in the stable, which was a place for the animals to stay warm and dry.
There was a cow there. There was a sheep there. There was a donkey. There was a camel. And Mary and Joseph stayed there too.
While they were there, baby Jesus was born, and Mary took him and wrapped him up warm and laid him in the manger.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed. The little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night.
An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, but they were terrified.
Do not be afraid,
I come with great news that will bring you such joy. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the babe wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
And all of a sudden, there were lots of angels saying,
Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests.
And the angel left.
Set the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see what I see? See what I see, a star dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite, with a tail as big as a kite.
Set the little lamb to the shepherd boy. As big as the sea.
When the angels left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to the sheep,
Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger.
And when they found him, they worshipped him.
When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king, Do you know what I know? In your palace warm, mighty king, Do you know what I know? A child shivers in the cold, Let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold.
Not far away, in a place called Jerusalem, there was an evil king named Herod. One day, after baby Jesus had been born, wise men came to Jerusalem looking for the newly born king of the Jews.
They asked King Herod where he was.
Where is the one who has been born king of the Jews?
We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him.
So the king asked his advisors,
Where is the king of the Jews to be born?
In Bethlehem.
In Bethlehem. Go and find him and let me know where he is so I can come and kill. Sorry, I mean worship him too.
So the wise men went and found baby Jesus by following his star.
When they found him, they worshipped him.
Sing glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph.
King Herod didn't really want to worship baby Jesus. He wanted to harm him. The wise men were warned by God about this, so they went home another way.
When he realized that he had been outwitted, he was furious.
I am really mad!
He was determined to destroy the newborn king. So King Herod ordered the killing of all boys in Bethlehem, 2 years old or younger, and sent his soldiers to Bethlehem to find the baby Jesus.
Go and find him and destroy him.
Again, God came to Joseph in a dream and warned him.
Get out of there!
And so they did.
And so Mary and Joseph and the little baby Jesus went to Egypt and stayed there until the evil King Herod died.
After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in the dream and to Joseph in Egypt and said,
"Get up, take the child and his mother to go to the land of Israel, for those who are trying to take the child's life are dead."
Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus came back from Egypt, and they went to live in the town of Nazareth again.
And that's where baby Jesus grew up until he was grown.
Now you know the story about how God sent his only son to be born as a baby so that later he could save everyone from their sins.
Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Come, let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare his room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven, nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness and wonders of his love. And wonders of his love, and wonders, wonders of his love. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven, nature sing.
Great job, guys. Let's give them another round of applause. And thank you, Bailey, for directing, and Debbie, for your oversight in all of this. Okay, you guys can make your way back, and if the worship team will come up, we will sing a closing Christmas carol. Let's stand as we close the service this morning. It's great to have you guys. You guys did a great job this morning, and for all the hard work that went into the program this morning. Well, thank you for coming this morning, and we invite you next Sunday for our 11 o'clock service and then for our 6 p.m. Candlelight Christmas Eve service. Let's just close in prayer. Father, we thank you that this story that we heard from the children, that is a simple story, but yet a story that is so profound, that changes lives over the course of history and can change our lives as well as we grasp what this is all about. So, Father, we just praise you and we thank you for your willingness to send your son and all that that means for us, that today, as we leave this place, we can go in your presence and your guidance. We just thank you for our children and teens, with those that we're working with them, and for this simple story that they so well told to us again today. Just be with us this week, I pray, and I ask all these things in Christ's name. Amen. We are dismissed.
Just...